Hello there, very welcome to Proactive. Dorian Gonsalves is joining us now from Belvoir Group because we're going to talk about your latest interim results. You've said that you have reported a 12% increase in revenues for the 6 months, which ended on the 30th of June 2022 to £15.4 million. And this is compared to £13.8 million in the same period a year earlier. But this is a slowdown from last year where revenue grew by 27% for the whole of the 12 months. We're also going to talk about your profit as well, which is down. And there's a lot going on here. And of course, 2021 is going to be a tough act to follow because so much happened then. Dorian, just give us the key takeaways, first of all, and then we'll dig into detail together.
No problem. Well, firstly, thank you for highlighting one or two of those facts. I think that because it is, you know, I think the results this time around just take a little bit of digging into to sort of fully understand the you know, what's behind them. So the bottom line is this is a business that is still growing. It's very robust. We're underpinned by recurring revenue, where a lot of businesses aren't. And if you take out, you know, you mentioned our revenues had sort of increased in the first half compared with first half last year. That's correct. And if you look at our revenue in the round, you can almost split it into two halves, and you can say that one half relates to financial services and the other half of our revenue relates to property. And what we've seen over the last 6 months is we've seen a normalization of the property sales market. So we forecast this 12 months ago. I said that, you know, it's very likely in 2022 that property sales transactions would return to pre-COVID levels. And just to illustrate my point, pre-COVID, we generally in the UK saw around 1.2 million house sales per year. That was pretty stable for 4 or 5 years. Then 2020 hit and house sales dropped because people couldn't have surveys and people just couldn't move house, couldn't easily move house in the first half of 2020. And then we saw various government measures that really poured fuel onto a very busy housing market, i.e. Stamp duty holiday. So then we saw a significant increase in transactions in 2021. So if the baseline was 1.2 million transactions, in 2021, we saw 1.5 million transactions. So that was the uplift from all of the factors around the stamp duty holiday and the sort of emotions that came with that. It wasn't just down to the stamp duty holiday. You know, people sort of wanted to move house. They wanted more space. There was a race for space, as it was called. And of course, when the property market gets very busy, there's a fear of missing out. You know, if someone doesn't move from a three bed to a four bed, they may not be able to afford that extra bedroom in 12 months' time. So, you know, all of these factors have an impact on the property market. And all we've seen in the first half of this year is a return to pre-COVID levels. That's it. So in the first half, we saw 600,000 transactions in the UK, which is exactly half of 1.2 million. You know, it's a return to normality.
Mm-hmm. And what would you say is coming up? Because there's a lot of pressures going on. Of course, we've got higher inflation, we've got mortgage rates, rents are a squeeze for a lot of people. You know, what are you foreseeing and forecasting for you then?
Yes, I mean, if you look at the sort of the two halves of our business, so as I mentioned a few minutes ago, if you look at our revenue, you can cut it in half, and half of the revenue is financial services, and half of the revenue relates to property. So if we just look at the property revenue for a second, 80% of our property revenue, so 80% of half of our revenue, comes from residential letting. So as you rightly say, that's renting properties. It's essentially what we call property management. So we manage the property at ground level. You know, we've got thousands of people in our franchise network, and we manage properties on a day-to-day basis. So as far as property management's concerned, that's the recurring element of our revenue. Tenants continue to pay their rent. We charge the landlords for managing their property, and we always that's how we've operated since we floated back in 2012. And interestingly, year on year, our portfolio is larger again now compared with first half last year. We're at 73,300 managed properties, which is a modest increase on this time last year. Mm-hmm. So property management remains strong. As you rightly say, rents are increasing. Interestingly, I mean, there are two different things there. You've got rents are increasing on new lets, by 8 to 10%, depending where you are in the country. But that's for new lets. That's not if you're renting a property and in situ. That's just for a new let. Yeah. If you're a current tenant across current tenancies, government is reporting that rents have increased by 3% year on year. So there's a difference there. New lets, 8 to 10% increase. Existing tenancies, around 3%. I suspect that will climb to 3.5% to 4% over the next 12 months. And I think we'll see very strong demand for rental properties for the next 2 to 3 years. So at the heart of our business, we are a property management business with recurring revenue, and that side of the business is likely to perform very well over the next 2 to 3 years.
Mm-hmm. There is a great level of uncertainty at the moment. How would you describe the business itself?
The business itself, I mean, we grew well during the financial crash, you know, sort of 2007 to 2010, because we were a lettings business and lettings performed very well during that period. We performed well during COVID. So we exceeded market expectations, our pre-COVID market expectations in 2020. We achieved market expectations in 2021. And this year, we've already said that we're in line with market expectations at this point in the year. So we're expecting a good second half. I mentioned an acquisition earlier. So we acquired a business in May. The upside of that comes in H2. We've got strong estate agency and mortgage pipelines of business that we can see. And we know that business will complete in the second half of the year. But the business itself is robust as always.
Mm-hmm. Robust as always, as you say. I just want to keep you for a second or two because you mentioned your acquisitions there. When are you likely to see those come to fruition?
Yeah, I mean, so we do two different types of acquisitions. So one is a corporate acquisition, such as the one we made in May. That was a mortgage business that added 60 more mortgage advisors to our business. So we completed on that in May. So we had 1 month of upside in these figures today, but the main upside will come in the second half. The different type of acquisition that we're involved in is that we help franchisees to acquire their competitors, and we've helped franchisees to acquire 120 businesses over the last 8 years. So you know, quite a high number. Those acquisitions reduced during 2020 and 2021, but I'm very pleased to say that the acquisition program has bounced back, and we're almost at similar levels as we were in 2019. Point being, in the first half of this year, we've completed on 2.2 million of franchisee revenue by acquisition. In the whole of last year, it was about 1.5 million. So we've already exceeded the whole of last year in the first half. In the second half of this year, we've got 4.4 million of acquisition deals in the pipeline. Not all of those will complete, but I suspect the majority will. And again, that's an upside to come in the second half of the year.
All right, Dorian, we'll leave it there. Thank you very much indeed for a thorough update there from Belvoir here on Proactive London.